Welcome back to the third part of solution. Now, solubility. Solubility is the maximum amount of substance that can be dissolved in a specific amount of solvent. It depends on nature of the solute, nature of the solvent, temperature and pressure. First, we can study about solubility of solid in a liquid. Example for solid in a liquid are salt in water or sugar in water. Other example, naphthalene in benzene or anthracene in benzene. And the thing is that sugar will not dissolve in benzene, or salt will not dissolve in benzene. Otherwise, naphthalene will not dissolve in water, anthracene will not dissolve in water. The reason is that every solid does not dissolve in a given liquid. It is observed that polar solute dissolves in polar solvents and non-polar solutes in non-polar solvents only. In general, a solute dissolves in a solvent if the intermolecular interactions are similar in the two. Or we can say that like dissolves like. Then we are going to learn about some terms in related to solubility. First one, dissolution. When a solid solute is added to the solvent, some solute dissolves and its concentration increases in the solution. This process is known as dissolution. That is, solid solute plus solvent, you are getting a solution. Some solute particles in the solution collide with the solid solute particles and get separated out of the solution. This process is known as crystallization, which is just opposite to the dissolution process. A stage is reached when two processes occurs at the same rate. Under such conditions, number of solute particles going into the solution will be equal to the solute particles separating out, and the state of dynamic equilibrium is reached. At this time, both the processes, first and second, that is crystallization and dissolution process, occurs at the same rate. Okay. And at that time, the concentration of solute in the solution will remain constant. Next one, saturated solution. A solution in which no more solute can be dissolved at the same temperature and pressure are called saturated solution. An unsaturated solution are the solutions in which more solute can be added or dissolved at the same temperature and pressure. In dynamic equilibrium, the concentration of solute in saturated solution is its solubility. And solubility, we know that the maximum amount of substance that dissolved in the solvent. And here, at saturated solution, that concentration is the maximum. So, here, concentration of the solute in the saturated solution is its solubility. Next one, effect of temperature. As we are considering as the solubility in equilibrium state, we have to consider Lee-Chatler's principle. According to Lee-Chatler's principle, endothermic reaction means it needs energy for the reaction to complete. Okay, for endothermic reaction, increase in temperature favors reaction or forward reaction. And for exothermic reaction, decrease in temperature favors forward reaction. Here the reaction is dissolution process. So here we can say, if the dissolution process is endothermic, that means delta H dissolution endothermic, so positive value. Okay, the solubility should increase with the rise in temperature. And if the dissolution process is exothermic, delta H value is negative, then the solubility should decrease with increase in temperature. Okay, next one, effect of temperature. Pressure does not have any significant effect on solubility of solid in liquid. It is So, because solid and liquids are highly incompressible and practically remains unaffected by change in pressure. Next one, we are going to study solubility of gas in a liquid. Many gases dissolve in water, but the thing is that the extent of dissolution is different for different gases. For example, oxygen dissolves only to a small extent in water to form dissolved oxygen, whereas hydrogen chloride gas is highly soluble in gas. On heating, what will happen? Next one is effect of temperature. Because the solubility of a gas in a liquid is highly exothermic, the dissolution of or the solubility of gas in a liquid is highly exothermic, the solubility of gas in liquid decreases with the rise in temperature. On heating, dissolved gas will escape out from the solution, thus increases the vapor pressure. Next one, effect of pressure. Effect of pressure. For understanding the effect of pressure, we have to consider the system shown here. The lower part is a solution and the upper part is gaseous system at a pressure P and temperature T. Now, increase the pressure over the solution phase by compressing the gas into smaller volume. This will increase the number of gaseous particles per unit volume over the solution and also rate at which the gaseous particles are striking the surface of solution to enter it. That means number of particles enter here will be increasing. So that the solubility also increases here. Henry was the first to give quantitative relationship between pressure and solubility. He said, according to his law, he said that the solubility of a gas in a liquid is directly proportional to the pressure of the gas. In other words, he stated that the partial pressure of the gas in vapor phase is proportional to the mole fraction of the gas in the solution. That is, partial pressure is directly proportional to the mole fraction of the solution. And by changing the proportionality by adding or multiplying proportionality constant KH, P is equal to KH into X, where KH is Henry's constant. We can plot a graph between partial pressure and mole fraction, and because they are directly proportional, you are getting a straight line by plotting these two things. Okay, then we can study about KH value. KH value is actually Henry's constant and is a function of nature of gas. That means it depends on nature of gas, and KH increases with increase in temperature. Another one, we have to consider the question, aquatic species are more comfortable in cold water rather than in warm water. Why? We can explain this with the equation, that Henry's law equation. Okay, that partial pressure is directly proportional to mole fraction, or P is equal to KH into X. We know that on increasing temperature, KH value increases. At a constant pressure, partial pressure, on increasing this part will decrease us the second term here, X here. That means when KH increases, X decreases at a constant P. Here partial pressure remains constant. So when the temperature increases, at warm water, temperature increases, then solubility decreases. Okay, so solubility of oxygen. So the amount of oxygen, dissolved oxygen present will be decreases with increase in temperature. So they will not be comfortable in living with the decreased amount of dissolved oxygen. That's why aquatic species are more comfortable in cold water rather than in warm water. Okay. Now we will going to discuss about applications of Henry's law. So that I'll discuss about Coca-Cola. Okay, the famous Coca-Cola bottle. If you are opening the Coca-Cola bottle, you can see bubbles are coming out, you know. What is that bubble? Actually, carbon dioxide gases coming out from the solution. What is the relation between that bubbles and Henry's law? Henry's law is nothing but as the pressure increases, solubility of gases in the liquid also increases. Is it? Is directly proportional to pressure is directly proportional to solubility or mole fraction. Okay, so here what is happening? In order to make carbon dioxide soluble, the bottle is sealed under high pressure. Okay, when we open that bottle, what will happen? The pressure inside the bottle get decreases and reaches to atmospheric pressure. So due to decreasing pressure, no, solubility also decreases. Solubility of carbon dioxide in that solution also get this decreases, and the carbon dioxide escape out. That is actually happening there. Next one is about mountaineers or scuba divers. Okay, so first mountaineers. At a high altitude, you know, this high altitude, it's a mountain and it's a high altitude, the partial pressure of oxygen, here the pressure is very low, so we can say that partial pressure of oxygen is less than that at the ground level. Okay, so we know that partial pressure is directly proportional to mole fraction or solubility according to our Henry's law. Is it? This lead to low concentration of oxygen in the blood and tissues of people living at high altitude or the mountaineers. Low blood oxygen, no, that causes climbers to become weak and unable to think clearly. This condition is known as anoxia, a medical condition which is known as anoxia. So we have to consider what the pressure at this that deep inside ocean. Here the pressure is very high. So when the scuba divers dive deep inside the ocean, they experience high pressure. This increased pressure increases the solubility of atmospheric gases in blood. And we know that atmospheric gases contain nitrogen, oxygen and other gases. When the divers came towards the surface, no? When the divers come towards the surface, what will happen? The pressure gradually decreases. Is it? And this releases the dissolved gases and leads to the formation of bubbles of nitrogen in the blood. This blocks capillaries and creates a medical emergency known as vent, and which are very painful and dangerous to life. Even death can happen. To avoid this condition, no, the tanks used by scuba divers are filled with the air diluted with the helium so that we can avoid this bend. Let us have one question. The question is like this. The cutting of onions at lower temperature is more comfortable than cutting of onions at room temperature. Why? Okay, so what is the reason? At lower temperature, the vapor pressure is low, so the onion will not produce too much of vapors. At room temperature, vapor pressure is high, is it? So more vapors are produced, bringing tears on cutting onions. Okay, thank you. In next section, we can solve some numericals related to this part. Okay, thank you.